team breakfast. A beer, whiskey, and a side order of rum. That's what your fans are out there in the info. We hear them all night.
It should be Kahlua and Bailey's at this point.
That's lunch. Yeah, it is my distinct honor and pleasure to be with two legends, two superstars in the racing industry. You know them, they need no introduction. But Danica Patrick and Jeff Gordon, good to see both of you.
Thank you.
And thanks for joining us on Good Day Orlando.
Thank you.
You've been talking to great folks all around the country.
Great day.
You saved us for the end. I appreciate you doing this morning. Danica, we've got to start with you because you've got to be living under a rock if we don't know that this Sunday is your final race for NASCAR.
Yes, people have caught wind of that.
Yeah.
The Danica double. I mean, that came from my agent calling me at the end of last year after hearing me say no to so many concepts and ideas for how to either finish my career or keep it going, whatever it is. And so he's like, what if you finished up at Daytona? And I'm like, that sounds good. And I was like, what about Indy? And he's like, that'd be great. So that became the plan. So there's the Danica double.
So there's nothing we can say or do to convince you to reverse your decision?
Well, I mean, Jeff came back and raced a whole bunch after he retired, didn't you?
Not by choice.
You raced like, what, at least almost 20?
No, I ran like eight races.
Yeah, like 20. Yeah,
now, this is where you should never say never. See, I thought I wouldn't do that, and I did, but I'm done with that now. But yeah. We'd love to have you come back.
He says never now. So I never say never because I also thought I would never do the Indy 500 again, but I'm doing that too. So
there's hope.
Yeah, no, I don't think there's a lot. There's not a lot of hope. Like, give me some chances is what you're thinking. Like one in a million.
Wow.
Oh, wow. The odds.
So you're telling me there's a chance.
Yes. I'll stick with that. Jeff, in your post-racing career, you've had a lot of success. Do you have time for things you never thought you would have had time for when you were racing?
Well, I mean, that's the flip side, right, is you hate to see your career come to an end, and it's emotional, and you put so much into racing your whole life to get there, but then you realize there is life after that, and that's what I'm excited about for Danica is being able to do things that you never had the time to do. This is a tough
plan
schedule.
Plan things on the weekend?
A weekend in general.
Not I mean, all.
And for me, it's spending time with my kids, that quality time on the weekends, taking some vacations during the summer. I mean, when you're racing, you have 5 days off, 6 days off, and you're back in the car. It was really nice to be able to take some actual time, about 2 or 3 weeks, with my family on a vacation. I've never done that in my whole life, so that was amazing.
I want to have our producers show the cover of your new book.
Oh, okay.
Pretty intense. Christina.
Good, it looks a lot better than what I look like right now.
Well, you do look very intense.
I mean, this suit's great. I mean, the green, the GoDaddy green is, like, memorable for everyone.
But
it was on the pole with the GoDaddy car. But
it just needs a little opening to show the abs.
Don't cut a window into it. That's what I love about my lightweight snowsuit is that I don't have to worry about the abs.
Well, you look good on the cover. But Jeff and I are about the approximate same height, same age, same weight, right? So our challenge, I'm guessing, I'm not speaking out of turn, but some squish in the mish is the problem. So what would you
advise? I know what your challenges are. Yes,
if I had to give any advice, I would say that diet. Abs are made in the kitchen.
Yes, they are.
You can do crunchies all day, but if you're eating pizza at night...
That's the problem.
Yeah.
See, and I'm also not burning 3,600 calories every weekend sweating in the race car.
Like, I'm worried about... We used to do marathons on Sunday, every Sunday, right? 38 marathons a year.
Right.
Because it's about the heart rate of a runner. So, am I going to have to just, like, sit on a Peloton bike or something like that for 4 hours while the race is going on to just sort of simulate it? Or else
I just found out I got to go on a diet.
I don't have to write a fitness book anymore.
Control. Last question for you because we're out of time. Are you putting on the helmet? You get behind the wheel on Sunday. Will you do anything differently this Sunday than you've done in the past?
You know, I've already done it different, and that's sort of hug and say goodbye in case I don't see certain people again. I'm like, well, if I don't see you, but I think that moment will depart just a little bit and be shared with my family and my friends. So those people that have been really close to me and important in my life, not just my career. So yeah, it'll be more emotional than I expect, I'm sure. As like my press conference was in Homestead about announcing the Danica double and being done full time. I mean, I thought I was going to keep it together. I did not keep it together at all. So I'm sure it'll be like that.
Yeah, but us in the TV world, we love seeing emotion like
liquid
that.
Liquid gold right there.
Yes.
Liquid gold.
Indeed. Well, good luck on Sunday.
Thank
we are
you.
Rooting for you.
Thank
it's
you.
Been an honor to talk with you.
Thank you.
As well.
Thank you.
So,